guys, welcome back to my channel. Today, I will show you an outstanding performance laser engraver and cutter, ACMER P3 48 watts. Its fully enclosed design makes it a good laser engraver for home use. This ACMER P3 48 watts can freely switch between 24 watts and 48 watts laser power for different engraving or cutting tasks. The most satisfying feature of the ACMER P3 is the HD camera, which allows for precise positioning and real-time preview of the engraving process. The ACMER P3 also features the innovative CoreXY motion structure, which offers more prediction and stability than other diode laser engravers. Besides this, many other desirable design details made the ACMER P3 even more user-friendly. In this video, I will test the ACMER P3 laser engraver and cutter in detail for you. So, let's jump right in. The ACMER P3's unboxing process was very convenient for me. It was almost ready to go out of the box. There was no annoying assembly process. When you purchase this ACMER P3 48 watts laser engraver, you will get those items. Before starting to test this amazing laser cutter, we take a look at its key features. The innovation of the ACMER P3 48 watts is its ability to freely switch between 24 watts and 48 watts laser power at the push of a button. But as you can see, the laser module of the ACMER P3 uses manual laser focusing method. The ACMER P3 is equipped with a 5MP HD camera. The camera is fixed on top of the lid, so I can do the engraving positioning very easily and precisely, and I no longer need to estimate the engraving position manually. Now let's begin the first test of laser engraving speed. The ACMER P3 48 watts have the fast laser engraving speed of any diode laser engraver and cutter I have seen. I use the 48 watts laser power mode to test the engraving speed on 3mm plywood. At only 20% of the laser power, the 48,000mm per minute or 800mm per second engraving speed was sufficient to laser engrave a clear pattern on the plywood. 800mm per second is an amazing speed for a diode laser engraver with an XY motion structure. To be honest, it has helped me to become more efficient in my engraving projects. This fast engraving speed is due to its high power of 48 watts and the innovative CoreXY structure, which is ultra precise and high speed. To test the cutting speed of the 48 watts laser, I still choose to use 3mm plywood as an example. As you can see, at 70% of the laser power, a 1,300mm per minute cutting speed is perfect for cutting 3mm plywood. This cutting speed is fast enough to save the loss of waiting time on large cutting projects. The 48 watts laser module allows for faster engraving and cutting speeds. The 48 watts laser mode has a laser spot size of 0.09 by 0.1mm. However, the 24 watts laser mode has a smaller laser spot size of 0.07 by 0.09mm. Therefore, the 24 watts can achieve more detailed engraving. So, I recommend using the 24 watt laser power mode to engrave more finely detailed projects. The switching is very simple. Just manually push the button on the laser module. In order to understand the difference between the 24 watts and 48 watts laser modes for engraving images, I did a test on 3mm plywood with different laser powers and speeds. The right side shows the results of the 24 watts laser mode with a power range of 50% to 100% and engraving speed of 32,000 mm per minute to 48,000 mm per minute and a line interval of 0.14 mm. Similarly, the right side shows the results of the 48 laser mode. At the 0.14 mm line interval, the engraving results of the 48 watts laser are generally over-engraved. In the 24 watts laser mode, I personally prefer that the engraving results are just perfect due to the lower laser power. So, if I want to engrave high definition patterns with clear details, I will choose 24 watts laser mode for engraving finely detailed images. To further understand the accuracy of camera positioning, I am now doing the positioning accuracy test for you guys. Before testing, I need to prepare a rectangle and a circle on 3mm plywood. The purpose of this is to have reference markers for positioning. Close the protective cover after placing the plywood with the positioning reference markers in the machine. Then click the camera on the light bulb to take a picture. I will draw four small rectangles on the light bulb. Draw them to the four corners of the large rectangle in the picture and align them with the edge of the large rectangle. Similarly, I will draw a rectangle with size the same length of the circle's diameter and tangent it to the circle. In this way, I complete the engraving positioning. If after engraving, the drawn patterns perfectly overlap the reference markers on the plywood, then it means that the positioning accuracy of the camera will be perfect. Let's wait and see. The results don't disappoint me. The drawn patterns were accurately engraved in the preset position and aligned with the reference markers. I am pleasantly surprised by the amazing positioning accuracy of the ACMER P3. For For CoreXY structure laser engraving machine, XY axis movement synergy has an important effort on engraving quality and accuracy, especially when engraving circular seams to obtain smoother lines. Perfect motion synergy between the X and Y axis is required to realize the movement stability of the CoreXY structure. The text results show that the ACMER P3 has excellent stability and accuracy, even at 30,000 mm per minute. Rectangles of different scales were achieved with very smooth lines, and the edges and top corners perfectly coincide with circles. Similarly, large circle seams achieve a smooth effect. However, when I look closely at the small side circles in the center, the circles were not perfectly engraved. To find out where is the critical value of the ACMER P3 in terms of movement speed and perfect circle engraved when engraving small, less than 10 mm diameter circles, I then take the results of engraving small circles with a diameter of less than 10 mm at different engraving speeds. The engraving results show that when the engraving speed is faster than 6,000 mm per minute, the circles are not perfect. In conclusion, if you want to get a very perfect circular pattern, I recommend setting the engraving speed below 6,000 mm per minute. If you are engraving a straight line pattern, then it will not be constrained by the speed. The regular safety features are standard in laser engravers nowadays, which is not worth telling here. But the ACMER P3 has a nice design that I found very useful. The laser engraving will stop automatically when the protect lid is open. But when the lid is closed, the laser engraving tags will resume automatically. This small design in ACMER P3 allows me to open the lid during the engraving process to observe the engraving results closely, then close the lid to resume laser engraving. It is important to be aware of the danger of the fumes when using a laser engraver, since the ACMER P3 has an enclosed design. Even without an air purifier, the smoke can be exhausted outside by simply connecting an exhaust pipe. I tested the indoor air quality when I used the ACMER P3 48 watts at home. The test result showed that the air quality is good, so I can use ACMER P3 at home with complete confidence. The ACMER P3 48 watts laser cutter works with a low noise level. When I tested the noise level using a decibel meter at a distance of 30 centimeters from the machine, it shows only about 33 decibels. In terms of actual sensation, I did not feel disturbed by the noise. I'm therefore very satisfied with the ACMER P3. After this period of virus performance tests and practical experience, I can confidently recommend the ACMER P3 to you. I think it is already in the top tier of desktop diode laser engravers. Ease of use does not fully define the ACMER P3. It also has super stable XY axis motion, high definition engraving capability, and precise camera positioning. All in all, the ACMER P3 is an excellent laser engraver and cutter that is worth buying. See you next time.